Highway with Green Apples is a 1995 short story, almost a novella, by the Korean author Bae Suah. It tells of a woman in her mid-twenties who's run away from an unhappy parental home situation and established a precarious independence in a low-paid job in modern Seoul. She has a string of boyfriends and a collection of female acquaintances, but no one to whom she really feels attached. As far as she can tell, everyone else is as isolated as she is. She not only feels alone, but feels that she's best off alone. Her outlook on life is bleak. All I think about is death, she says at one point. The book's title is taken from a bag of green apples she buys from a dreary-looking woman at a roadside when she's on the way to the coast with one of her boyfriends. The same episode occurs at the beginning and end of the story. Time here has a cyclical element, and the author seems non-committal about whether everyday life merely feels repetitive or whether, in a more disturbing sense, it really is repetitive. There's a concert, for example, which seems to occur twice, but whose details seem too particular for such a precise repetition. It doesn't help that the narrator is drunk at the time. With a story like this, the reader always wants to know, is it a radically pessimistic take on human life generally? That is, does it have philosophical ambitions? Or is it simply about the quality of life experienced by a certain category of individual in a certain time and place? In this case, a young single female in 20th century Seoul. The latter would put it in the same class as Han Kang's 2007 The Vegetarian and Cho Nam-ju's 2016 Kim Ji-young, born 1982. The former would make it more of an existentialist text. Unfortunately, there's no way of knowing because the narrator draws no explicitly general and extended conclusions from her experiences. That's understandable, of course. This is a short story and the emphasis is on the events, the settings and the feelings. Added to which, just about everything fiction writers could possibly say in the life is meaningless line has probably already been said. In the end, I don't think it matters. Bae Suah is on record as having reservations about her literary style. I don't think I write really good sentences, she said recently in The Guardian, but this is well written. It's pessimistic enough to convince the reader, but detached enough not to be dispiriting. And of course it does show us one side of the South Korean capital. Just not the only side, I hope.